Alright, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be showing you how to get this look. I'm going to be showing you my skincare this morning, my makeup, and how I did my hair. So if you want to see this video, go ahead and keep on watching. And don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up if you like what I'm doing. And leave a comment if you want to see something a little bit different next time. Alright guys, I'm going to go ahead and let's get started. So we're going to start with the face. So far I have brushed my teeth because it's early morning, cleansed my face, there's a hair on this, cleansed my face, and most importantly, exfoliated my face. So if there is one thing in my whole arsenal that I would like need to have with me at all times, it would be these Genius pads. So they're the most expensive thing in my skincare routine, but like for a good reason. These not only help exfoliate your face, but also moisturize your face. And I cannot remember the last time I had something that exfoliated my face and moisturized it at the same time. So, and then, so let's get started. I got this little Try Me set from when I just went shopping, and it's supposed to be a calm set. So it's like attached to this. And I just want to give it a try today. Normally I do the anti-aging, but we're going to see how this one is. This one is less, fewer steps as well. So I kind of want to do that one today, since today I am going to meet my boyfriend's parents. Just kidding, I've met them before, but we're going to go have lunch. So I kind of need to get ready earlier. Okay, so we have the cleanser, which you use in the shower. So that's this, actually. It comes with this size. Don't need that. Eye serum, moisturizer, and eye gel. Wait, facial serum. Okay. Which one comes first? Let's read the box. It probably says on the box. Directions. Apply every... apply evenly all over face and neck in the morning and evening. After the application of serum. Oh, the moisturizer. So the moisturizer's first. Got it. Okay. I don't know why I'm like getting frantic. We got this. So we're gonna start with the eye gel. I always like to start with the eyes because I kind of just like with the eyes like go out with this. You'll see what I mean. Ooh, it's cooling. I like that. And so pretty much with every skincare routine that I use the Genius Ultra because whenever you're using any kind of device to help your skincare, it, you know, helps it last longer because it isn't getting absorbed into your fingertips, and it just is better for application. This one in particular warms up and it vibrates, so it also helps, you know, it penetrate your pores better. So yeah, it's an investment, but I definitely, this is something that I never really thought I would have. Wow, this eye gel is really like light. Sorry, it's like spreading everywhere. That's good. Before I really got into like learning about skincare, when I used to see those devices, I always thought they were kind of pointless, really. I didn't see like a reason for having them, but after I started using them, I actually did see a really big difference in how my skin started to look and just how much more potent it made everything that I was using. So if I was using like an acne treatment or, you know, an anti-aging thing, it would just work a lot better. Oh, I wonder if this has SPF in it. I hope it does. It should. Let's see. But yeah. Let me see. For use. Doesn't say. Yeah, so I'm going to get ready. I already showered. I'm going to get all dressed up. It's May right now. Actually, it's May 5th. It's Cinco de Mayo. So, if anyone cares, it is Cinco de Mayo. For anyone that has any history on it, that it is not a Mexican, it's not Mexico's Independence Day. Actually, Mexico's Independence Day is, what's it called? In September. So a lot of people tend to think that Cinco de Mayo is like us selling the Mexicans 4th of July, basically, their Independence Day. That's not true. It's pretty much just like a made-up holiday from like Americans, because from what I heard, Mexicans don't celebrate it. Like, there's only one small connection in Mexico, which is from a small town that they won like some battle on May 5th, but other than that, you know, it's not really celebrated. Oh, and the good thing about this Genius Ultra 2 is that it helps, what it does is it actually turns off automatically for you, so it only goes on for a minute. It's just kind of good to have a timer. It's almost like when you used to have like a timer for your toothbrush when you were a kid. And then the serum. Wait, I was supposed to put the serum on after, yeah? Daily moisturizer. Apply evenly after the application of serum. Oh, I was supposed to do the serum first. Turn the apply after. It's fine. We're just gonna. Oh. Interesting. This formula is really, like, gel-like. Whoa. The one that I'm used to using is, like, really thick. But again, it's for anti-aging, so it's just, like, a lot more jam-packed. This one's the Calm, which means it's made for people that have sensitive skin. Which I don't really know that I have sensitive skin. I mean, one time I tried to get my eyebrows threaded, and like that did not work out very well for me. Basically, it just made my whole face like red and irritated. So maybe I have kind of sensitive skin. But yeah, I always like trying new skincare. Then I'm going to do a series for you guys where I try different skincare products, because I saw this like list the other day, and it was for crazy skincare products, and one of them was this like eye mask thing. So if anybody's watched the X-Men, it was basically like that shape. Actually, I forgot the name of the guy. Rogue? No, that's the girl. But yeah, it was weird. I want to try it. It's supposed to help with like eye stuff, whatever. I'm 23, so you're supposed to start your anti-aging as soon as possible. I'm just gonna rub that in over there. Okay, well that's it for about my skincare. Let me start doing my makeup. And my team. Do you guys like incense? I got this one. It's called Palo Santos. It's actually from Bolivia, which is where I'm from, or which is where my dad is from, I should say. My dad moved to LA when he was in like middle school. That's where I was born, but that's where I was raised. But yeah, so this is from a sacred tree in Bolivia. It smells really good, if you guys ever want to try it. I love incense. But you have to get like the good stuff, because not all incense are created equal. It could really like harm your skin, damage your skin. But yeah, I'm gonna leave this with this. I'm ending the skincare part area sequence. But you need to exfoliate, but you can't over exfoliate. So if you find a product that helps you exfoliate on a daily basis and moisturize, your skin's gonna be looking so good. It's basically like a mini microabrasion facial. Which, if you look online and you try to get one, those are super expensive. So this has 60 pads in it. So you can use this once a day for 2 months. And it costs about the same as one of those like really big facials. So definitely worth it, in my opinion. So, okay. Let's get my little makeup out. Green over here. I'm gonna go for a soft look today, but also I'm going to do my eyelashes. I'm gonna put some lashes on. Wait, I only have three. Oh, there it is. I know, that's gross. I have a lot going on in here. I need to keep the packaging. I'm gonna be smarter. Start with my primer. What should I talk about today? It's May, Cinco de Mayo. So we were talking about how it's Mexico's Independence Day. What else? April showers bring May flowers. Has anybody been seeing any nice blooms recently in their part of wherever you live? I actually recently just heard that like expression, April flowers bring May showers, and I was thought that was super cute. No. Maybe. Anyways, April showers bring May flowers. Oh, so I am from LA. I live in Northern California right now, but when I was living in LA, which is only like less than a year ago before I moved, I need more concealer. There was this thing going on called the super bloom, which basically just means that it was like the time that California had gotten like the most water in so long. So all the flowers were blooming and it was like looking really pretty. And we were seeing pictures of these people in like these gorgeous fields of like lavender and just like beautiful whatever. So we decided to go to this lake where, hold on, I know this never just like replays. This lake called Lake Elsinore, which is about, 2 hours away from LA, something like that. And so we made the trip out and there was absolutely nothing there. Like it was so sparse. We found like a few fields of flowers and it's just, that's just one thing I think people don't really talk about. Like if you're from, if you're not from LA and you think about LA, there is no nature anywhere. It's just non-existent. Like, and the nature that is there is just pitiful compared to anywhere else in the world, honestly. Hold on, I think Robbie's still looking for that brush. Are you still looking for the brush?
I'm looking for the toothpaste.
Oh. Yeah, I have it. Here you go. Oops. So yeah, I went with him to the Super Bloom. And there was nothing there. Like, I mean, nothing. Oh yeah, so like, in California, I guess there was just like one field, honestly. Like one field that bloomed. And so everyone flocked there to go take photos. Because it's just like such a rarity where now I'm living in Northern California and it's like a different world. It's pretty much like everywhere else except for like any desert like Arizona where it's just like luscious and green. Like right now all the trees are like so full and like beautiful and just, I don't know, I really, really love it. Don't get me wrong, I love LA as well. I love the city life, but it's so nice to like kind of be out in nature for a bit. And be out in nature, like live in a city, but you know what I mean. Just like try something new with it. But yeah. Let me know, like, where do you guys live? Do you guys live in a place where, ooh, I went to Germany during October. And it was, okay, Germany during October, also Chicago during October. It was beautiful. Like, I haven't been here during the fall time, but seeing all the leaves change and everything, just little things that, like, make me so happy because you don't have that when you grow up in LA. You don't have anything. It's olive. Yeah. Okay, so, like I said, I'm gonna go for, like, kind of, like, a lighter look today, so I'm gonna do more. Like face powder. Because I talked about this in my last video, but my foundation is just not matching my skin tone because I've been getting a little more sun lately. And, yeah, it's just pretty questionable there on the shade match. But you know what? We're going to make it work, hopefully. I have hope. I have high hopes. Yeah, let's keep talking about the weather. Why not? So yeah, spring is a beautiful time. I can understand why so many people want to get married around this time of year. Springtime is just pretty. Everything's blooming. It's a nice time. Everyone's like, it's like, it represents new beginnings too. You know, which I'm all about. I am all about starting over. And just starting fresh. And speaking of starting fresh, I'm gonna put a different song on because this one is not playing correctly. I've been listening to a lot of like Avicii, and ever since he passed, I'm just getting like super emotional over, I don't know. EDM music to me, maybe to most people that really like it, really gets me emotional because of the times that I shared it with the people that I shared it. It was always like, you know, at a festival or just something where you're just like in such a good, happy place and just like, it's like otherworldly, you know? So I've been like thinking about that a lot, but also thinking about how like, I don't know, time has passed and I'm not really into that, the whole like music festival thing. I think it's mainly because I don't drink anymore. That kind of takes the fun out of it, honestly. It's not really fun to be around a bunch of drunk people when you're sober. So there's that. Alright, let me see what I can do with these brows. I'm trying to do my eyeshadow first, actually. Ooh, so I did this new technique for me. It's new for me. Yesterday, that I really liked the way it made my eyes look. Because my eyes, I don't know, they're pretty hooded. So let me show you. What I did was I took the brown. I took the brown on the tip of the brush and I basically angled it in like this so to like get my crease. And then I just kind of blended it out like that. Let's see if I can like recreate it. Because I really like to make my eyes look really deep, and the way you can do that is by putting a dark color on your crease. Also, my eyes are kind of wide set, so I like to focus a lot of attention into the middle part of my eyeball. Not really like to drag it out too much because my eyes are already kind of like, they're not really round shaped, they're more like almond, so I kind of like to just make them rounder. See, it's kind of like that. I need to blend it out more, but get the idea. Yeah, what's your favorite season? Leave a comment down below. My favorite season is fall. I think I'm biased because I was born in the fall, but that's my favorite season. I'm not changing it. A lot of people like summer. Actually my least favorite season because I cannot stand the heat. I'm just like the type of person, like, leave a comment down below if you overheat a lot or anytime, because that is me and no one seems to understand why I don't like the heat or summer. And it's like, because I can't stand being hot, can't stand overheating. Like, I just, oh god, just like anything like sunbathing or being like, I can't even, like, just sunbathing or doing anything that's hot, like being in a jacuzzi, just, like, I can't, it's the worst. It's all the worst. I'd rather be in, like, a snow cabin, you know? Ooh, I used the wrong brush for this. Ooh, I just dripped into my shimmers. I kind of want to do, like, a shimmery eye now. Now for lashes, I'm going to go ahead and take these bad boys, take any little linty lints off of them, and put them on. So let's do this. So yeah, I'm keeping the eyes like super simple. It's still daytime. I don't know, I'm going to like accessorize the heck out of my outfit, so I'm trying to be somewhat so. I've really been meaning to get some lash glue that you can put on with an applicator, kind of like a little brush. Worst thing is like when your lashes stick to your tweezers. Anyone else agree? Yes? Anyone else feel the struggles that I go through? So I've been really meaning to get some lashes that are like, oh my gosh, that are not winged. Because I'm trying to do like things to make my eyelashes look bigger. I mean my eyeballs. Oh my gosh, I'm hard to put. I'm redoing this. Redoing my eyeballs look bigger. And one of the things you can do is to, instead of getting, so this is a winged lash, you can get lashes that are just kind of like evenly, just like an E, like even, like they're more like longer in the middle. Basically, instead of being longer on the end, they're longer in the middle. I think my Lily Lashes Miami, like those are the ones I'm talking about. But the reason why you want to do that is because whenever you put, excuse me, sorry headphone users. The reason you do that is because if you do an eyelash that's kind of like out on the end, and if you have it like too down, it like makes your eye look droopy. So also, if you have a winged liner that's just too long, like it can pretty much, when you're trying to make your eyes look bigger, the shape of your eye lash is really important too. Like a lot of people have been really super into the wing look and everything, and like that's great if you have really big eyes, like really big round eyes. You can do a wing liner, you can do like whatever, and it won't really make your eyes look that much smaller. But if you already have naturally small eyes like I do, I kind of want to try to stay away from that just so that my eyelashes, my eyeballs can look as big and as round as possible. See? Like this. Oh my gosh. Keep getting the glue on it. You know, I'm just going to like leave it alone for a bit. And you want to like make sure just like the edges are always up. Like I said, especially this one, you don't want it to droop down. You get the other one now. I like how I'm trying to go for a subtle look and I'm putting eyelashes on. Like, this is. On what world? In what world? Yeah, I know people always hate when. Well, I personally hate when gurus, like, don't do their eyebrows in videos. Like, they always skip that part out. Like, they probably have, like, a tutorial on how to do their brows on their channel, but. They just like never do it, and I understand now why, because it just takes too much time. No one wants to sit there and watch that. Maybe, I don't know, you guys will, so you guys are going to, because I'm gonna film it. I'm gonna drive. Oh god, so my left is not my dominant hand. Oh shiza. Oh, there it is. Oop, there. Speaking of Yas Queen, I want to watch Broad City. Anyone else watch that show? It's on Hulu. 10 out of 10 would recommend. Oh my gosh, am I going to have to redo these two? I am. I'm just accepting it. It's coming off. I'm going to have to do these again. And restart my music again. I need tea. Much better. Okay. Why is my nose runny? Oh. Okay, I'm complaining too much now. We're going to stop. We're going to reset. Oh. Sorry, I just got like a huge glob. That was way too much. See, the one good thing, though, about putting lashes on a second time, I really don't know if this is a hack. Like, I just have to do this because I tend to mess them up. But if you, like, put glue on your eyelash, on your eyelid before, and then you let it kind of dry, and then you put lash glue on your actual lashes, then it sticks a lot better. Okay, so then what I like to do with a little angled brush, another thing to make my eyes look bigger, is go in with a brown and go under my eyes and just kind of smudge that out. Again, we're going for a soft daytime look here, guys. Don't want to be too extra, but also, if you're a big city girl, it's kind of hard to avoid. My definition of subtle is not everyone else's definition of subtle. And I'm okay with that. I've accepted it. I've learned to love it. Okay. Sweet. Next, brows. So many. Okay, so I'm gonna do it with this first. So this is a really light brown. This is a lot lighter than my shade, so I kind of like to go in and just fill this in. And then we're gonna go in with a felt tip and like really do the little hairs details. My eyebrows have like changed shape so much over my lifetime. They have seen some really bad days. They've seen some better days. Usually the days where I do my eyebrows like the best, I don't even leave the house. Nobody sees them. Nobody's there to witness them. It's tragic. But yeah, my natural eyebrow shape like goes, like basically like if they go down, like all this is like has hair. I have to like pluck all that to get even like a decent arch. That's why my eyebrows are so sparse. That's okay. If Jeffree Star can draw on his eyebrows from nothing, I can draw my eyebrows from not as much. He's an inspiration, you see? Jeffree inspiring us every day. Also, I think I have a secret bias for why I love him, because he's also a Scorpio. So, just so you know, anyone that is a Scorpio, I'm already gonna like you. Two peas in a pod. Okay, so yeah, basically just get like the rough outline of it done. Down. And I'm gonna zoom in for you guys. So, I went in with the regular eyebrow to just kind of fill them in, and now I'm going to go in with more detail with a felt tip semi-permanent henna brow. This has been my favorite little newest eyebrow product for 2018. They have different shades too. I know this one's pretty dark. Yes, they are thick today. Okay. That's another thing I've just kind of learned to accept. Some days your eyebrows are going to be different shapes or different thicknesses than others. You know, you just got to work with it. Just got to roll with it. If they're looking good, they're a little thicker than normal, so be it. You kind of brush them through. This really helps just kind of soften them. Blend it out more. Oh yeah. Alright. Okay, looking good. Looking good, ladies! Looking good! This one's questionable. What had happened? What? Oh, moving on. Sorry. Let me adjust my camera. Oh gosh. Okay. Last but not least, I'm gonna do my hair. So, we are going to do a classic easy look, which is a Ariana half updo look inspired look. Because my hair is kind of. Okay, so basically, what I do. Oh my god, I didn't finish my face. Wait, hold on. What? Yeah, wow. I didn't bronze or like blush. Okay, so going back to my face, let me just get that going and done. Bronzed all up. Sorry, I got something in my eye there. Yes. Yes. Give me some life. Give me some color. God, I'm getting a lot. I'm getting out of hand here as far as I was trying to go for a, oh, I just like woke up like this look. It's turned into, nope, I definitely spent 30 minutes on this look. Which, you know what? 30 minutes isn't bad. But I think it's closer to 40 minutes, but whatever. Whatever. Oh. Hashtag doing your makeup without your eyeglasses. Where's my brush? Oh, here. Okay. Yes, here. Yeah. Bronze that part up. It's also what I like to do to make my nose snatch. Just bring it up. Gotta blend that out in a little bit. That's okay though. Oh. Yes. Uh-oh. Went a little too small there. That's okay, we can fix that. We can fix that. Not by using a bigger brush. By using our foundation brush. We're just going to go right back down in the middle there. Uh-huh, uh-huh. Yes. And then with this brush, just kind of get the tip of the nose nice and brown. With that jawline. Contour that jawline. Yes. Get it in there. Because, you know, why not? Looks nice. Sorry. I can't be without my music for more than 2 seconds. High seas. Rising. Help me out, SoundCloud. Blush. Blush is next. It's hot. I don't know if you can tell by the sweat on my face. And highlighter. Highlight. I'm gonna do a little bit on the inside. A little bit on this part. A little bit on this part. Oh, a lot of it on that part. Ooh. Add more. Let's just do the lips now. I need a closer mirror. I like to really focus the color in the center, again, just bringing all the attention to the center of my face. I don't like to widen my face. Okay, I can't talk, sorry. Oh my gosh, I'm so outside of land. But yeah, I try to do anything to avoid widening my face. High key. Okay, I don't have the, gosh, she still looks so pale. Like, what is happening? Guys, I'm struggling today. You know what, we're just gonna bring that bronzer in. Ooh, just a little bit. That's fine. Okay, so for the hair, I'm going to do like a half do up here. So basically just with your fingers doing the same thing on both sides, you're going to get it pretty high up, like this high up. Okay. And then you just want to kind of like comb through it to make sure it's nice and flat. And I have bangs, so I like to kind of bring them out. Like that. Let's see. So you gotta put those in here. And like depending on the look that you're going for, you can get like I kinda like to have it a little longer. Yeah, like that. This is a little too long though. Get out of here. Where's this coming from? I like to get it like at the highest point possible. I like to do it at the top of here. To as many times as you need to make sure it's nice and tight. It's not falling all over the place.
Oh my gosh, okay, so everybody's here. But I'm almost done, so we're just going to finish my hair here and put on my accessories. I like to do one of these looks as well. So it's also good if you like have your hair is kind of dirty on the dirtier side. Okay, all right. People are here. We need to get ready. Okay. I'm gonna make sure I'm in focus. Okay. So I'm gonna go with the two earring look here. I have two piercings, so I'm gonna do one of these. And then I like my little Scorpio earring. Just if you guys can see it, I don't know, it's my favorite. And then I'm gonna go in here to this other side. Isn't that the worst? Like when you're getting ready and then people start showing up at your house. Well, either way, this is the finished look. So if you guys, I hope you guys liked this video. I know it was kind of a long one, but I kind of like showing you how I get ready from like beginning to end. So go ahead and subscribe to see more videos like this. Leave a comment if you want me to make a whole video being more in depth on like one thing in particular. And yeah, other than that, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you on the next one. All right. Love you. Bye.